Hello friends, so today we are going to record one sample paper. We are providing solutions for a sample paper for DSSSB, PGT and TGT computer science. Right now we are covering section A, which is a general section. You can just see the solutions for this section A. This is sample paper, and we'll also upload the solutions for section B later. So we are going to look at section A first. So we are going to look at general intelligence and reasoning ability section first. We're just going to see the questions. I'll give you the explanations also related to the terms used in the question, so that whenever later also you're solving some questions, you'll have some tips and some related terms you'll be familiar with. So directions for these questions are, in each of the given questions, you have to select the related word from the alternatives. Like see, they have given that eye is related to cataract. Eye is related to cataract. Similarly, they are asking what would be skin related to. So we know that cataract is a disease of eye. Cataract is a condition in which your vision decreases. Okay, you cannot see properly. Eye lens becomes opaque, a bit of opaque. So similar condition in skin, similar disease in skin is eczema. Eczema, option 3, right? So this pyorrhea is a disease of periodontal tissue and causing shrinkage of gums and loosening of teeth. So this is a disease related to gums. Okay, this leads to loosening of teeth. Fine. And this sinusitis is inflammation of sinus. This is inflammation of sinus related to sinus. Fine. And it is a cavity of bone or tissue. Sinus is a cavity of bone or tissue. So sinusitis is inflammation of sinus. Okay. And eczema. This eczema refers to inflammation of skin. Fine. Inflammation of skin. And with itching and discharge from blisters. Itching and discharge from blisters. So eczema is a disease related to skin. Look at the next question. Vitamin E is related to carrot. As similarly, vitamin C is related to what? So we know that carrot is a source of vitamin A. So the question is asking about the source of vitamin C out of these given options. So we know that orange or any other citrus fruits, lemon, orange, every citrus fruit is going to be a source of vitamin C. So correct option is going to be orange. Now this is a question related to alphabets. There's some coding, some specific code according to which ACF is related to GIL. First you need to find out the code, find out the scheme that they are using to relate these alphabets. Similarly, you are required to relate MOR. So we know that you must have learned that every alphabet is having a specific number according to its position. Like A comes first in the order of alphabets, so it is allotted number 1. B would be 2, C would be 3, and so on. Similarly, Z would be 26. So if you just look at this pattern, A, C, F. A is 1, C is 3, F is 6. Now what have they done is, A is related to G, which is 7. I, which is 9, and L, which is 12. Okay, you can just count the position. So what I can see here is, after adding 6 to each number in this sequence, I am getting the alphabet of the next sequence. Okay, adding 6 to 1, I am getting 7. Adding 6 to 3, I am getting 9. And adding 6 to 6, I am getting 12. Fine. So this is how I am getting this sequence. This is how the letters are related. So what do I do is, in adding 6 to these alphabets also, to the positions of these alphabets also, I am just counting next sixth alphabet. From M, if you count the next sixth alphabet, you're going to get S. You can just count M, after M, six alphabets, N, O, P, Q, R, S. So you're getting S. After O, if you count six alphabets, you're going to get O, P, Q, R, STU. So we are getting U. And after R, if you are counting 6 alphabets, you are going to get R STU VW X. So the letters related to this sequence are going to be SUX. This is going to be the correct option. Fine, we are just adding 6 to the positions of all these alphabets. Okay. Look at the next question. In the following question, you have to find the odd word or the odd number from given alternatives, right? You just, there is a sequence that every option is following. One option would not be following that scheme, that pattern. We have to find that odd one out, okay? So the first question is, the options are sweater, muffler, socks and shawl. So we all know these all are woolen wear, right? All are used in winters. But the odd one out of these would be socks. Socks, correct answer for this is going to be socks. Why? Because sweater, muffler, shawl are all wore on upper body. You are wearing these above your waist, right? And socks we are wearing on foot. So that is why this is the odd one out. This is odd one out of all the options. Now look at the next question, 1942, 1937, 1935, 1925. So the odd one out is going to be 1942 because only this is even number, even, and all the other options are odd. Okay, see, they can be any pattern related to these type of questions. Okay, maybe sometimes they'll give years which are having some historical relevance. Okay, and one year which is not historically relevant. So maybe that way also you'd be required to find odd one out. Here this was a simple question. All the other numbers were odd. Only one number was even. So that was the odd one out. Now we have to arrange the leaves according to their size. Okay, so maybe most of you are familiar with this. Maybe some of you do not know this, but you can just see this here. Tamarind leaf is the smallest. Tamarind leaf is smallest out of all these. Then we'll have mango leaf, okay, right? Then we are having papaya leaf, banana leaf. Maybe you or most of you would be knowing, banana leaf are quite big in size, quite large. Okay, so they would be the largest of all. So according to this, the answer is going to be option 3. So all these type of information you can just see. Maybe you would remember if they're asking something similar again in the paper, then it would be beneficial for you. Look at the next question. In the following questions, a series is given and one term is missing in each series. So you are supposed to require to choose the correct alternative to complete the series. First, you are just going to see the two complete series, find the pattern of the series, then we'll complete the missing terms. See, one is square of 1, right? 25 is going to be square of 5 and this 81 is going to be square of 9. Now, When I add 4 to 1, I am getting 5. When I add 4 to 5, I am getting 9. Similarly, this is square of 2. Add 4 to 2, you are getting 6 square. Add 4, 10 square. This is square of 3. Add 4, 7 square. Add 4, 11 square. So this has to be 121 or 11 square. This is going to be 121. Now this is 4 square, add 4, 8 square, 12 square, right? So this is going to be 64. So against question marks, we are going to have 121 and 64. This is option 1. Fine. So this is how you're going to solve questions on series. As soon as you see some square numbers, you can just relate. Okay. You can just think that some series related to squares has been given. Then we are looking at their bases. Okay. Bases. How are they related? How are they progressing? They are just the squares of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So this was just a square question based on square series. Fine. Now look at the next question. What are they doing is 4 to 3, they've decreased 1. 3 to 2.5, they decreased 0.5. Again, half. So in each case, we are just decreasing half of what we decreased earlier. In first time, we decreased 1, then half of 1, then half of half. Now, half of 0.25, which is going to be 0.125. So when you subtract 0.125 from 2.25, you are going to get 2.125. So this is going to be the correct option, okay? Correct option for this question. Now, they've given that if 8th of April falls on Monday, what would be the 30th day of that month? Okay, so we know that a week constitutes of 7 days, right? And each day is going to come back after 7 days with that. That is, if 1st of a month of any month was Monday, then again on 8th of same month, we are going to have Monday. Also, on 15th of same month, again Monday. Then again on 22nd of same month, we are going to have Monday. So, each day is going to repeat itself after an interval of 7 days, right? So, if 8th of April was Monday, then 15th of April, 22 April, and 29 April, all of these are going to be Monday. If 29 April is Monday, then they're asking 30th of that month. If 29 April was Monday, 30th April is definitely going to be Tuesday. So the correct option is going to be option 3, Tuesday. Fine. Now, from the given alternative, select the word which cannot be formed using the letters of given word. So they have given a word establishment, establishment, and they are asking that which of the given options cannot be formed out of these. So see, first option, look at the first option, table, table. So we are having table. So table can be formed, right? This can be formed. Now look at the second option, blunt. So we need blunt. So we have B, we have L, we have N, we have T, but we are not having U. So this cannot be formed, right? This cannot be formed. Now look at tense. So we are having T-E-N-T-S. Tense can be formed. Similarly, state, S-T-A-T-E. State can be formed. So only blunt cannot be formed. So correct option is going to be second one, option 2. Now, if Sunday is coded as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and big is coded as 6, 7, 8, how would you encode Sandway? See, whenever these kind of questions are given, this is 1-to-1 mapping, okay? 1-to-1 mapping means that each letter that they have already given in coded letter that they have given the codes for Sunday and big. You are going to use the code, the corresponding number for each letter from these sets only. Okay, what does this mean? You're required to encode Sandway. So we are just going to look at the code of S from Sunday. Now in Sunday, S was coded as 0. So I am coding here S as 0, right? Now A was coded as 4. So I'll write 4. N was coded as 2, so I'm writing 2. D they have coded as 3, so 3. B is 6. Again A was 4 and Y was 5. So the code for Sandway is going to be 0, 4, 2, 3, 6, 4, 5, which is option 2. Okay, option 2. So this is 1-to-1 mapping. Okay, you do not need to apply any brain here. You just see which letter is coded as which number and just copy. Okay, sometimes they're going to give some difficult codes which would be based on the letters number, letters position in alphabets, and or adding 1 to them or something like that. But when they're giving some coding like this, they're giving two words and their corresponding codes, then you just check the each letter from the required word and just put its corresponding number in the code. Okay, look at the next question. Select the correct combination of mathematical signs to replace asterisk sign and to balance the following equation. So they have given an equation and you're required to put some mathematical signs in it so that this equation becomes true, becomes balanced. So one thing that you can note here is we are following a rule in maths which is known as BODMAS. What does BODMAS mean? This is bracket. This is of, divide, multiply, addition and subtraction. This is the actually the order of preference of the operations that we are going to perform. This is how priority decreases. Okay, this is the direction of this arrow indicates that this is how priority is decreasing, which means that suppose you are given with the equation like this. Okay, you are given some equation like this, then what are the order of the operations that you are performing, right? See, there can be two, three ways to solve this. First way would be 5 into, I add this first, then I subtract it, answer would be 25, right? Second way would be, I subtract this first, add this. Again, I got the same answer. Then one way would be, I multiply this first, simultaneously subtract this. So see, we can get different answers if we are following different sequence of operations. But the point is which one is correct, okay? Which one is the right sequence? So according to this, we are deciding. See, we do not have any brackets in this equation. So B is gone. We are not having any off operation. Off is gone. We're not having division operation. We are having multiplication operation. So first priority will be given to multiplication. First operation that you're going to perform in this equation is multiplication. So 5 into 4 is going to be 20 plus 3 minus 2. Now next priority is addition. Addition. So we are performing addition. Then subtraction. So correct answer is going to be 21. This is correct answer. This is wrong. This is wrong. So this is why, so that there is no ambiguity in mathematical operations, we all are going to follow the rule of BODMAS. Okay, this is how we are going to decide the priority of arithmetic operations in any equation. Now see, in this question here, equal to sign, see, in every option equal to sign has to come. So this is the RHS of the equation. We need 6 here. Now you have to perform some operations. Some operations and on this side, such that after performing those operations, according to the rules of BODMAS, the equation must equate to 6. So just try. See, this is hidden trial. So just try. If we are just considering this first option, if we put a division sign here, here multiplication and here minus, then first priority will be given to division. 9 divided by 3, this is going to be 3. Okay, just look at it here. If I'm trying the first option, this is how my LHS is going to look. I'm just going to look at LHS because right side already we know that we need 6. So I'm trying with the first option first. So first priority will be given to division, then multiplication. So we are getting 6. So this is going to be the correct option. First is the correct option. Okay. Suppose first was not the correct option, then you'd have to try other options also. Just hit and trial and see which set of operations is giving us the required equation. Okay. So for these type of questions, what we can do is at the starting of the paper, as soon as you are going to get the paper, just write complete ABCD and their corresponding numbers. Okay, I'm going to do it now. Fine, so these are the corresponding numbers of the given alphabet. So now just see, for Raj, R is 18, A is 1 and J is 10. If you just add all these numbers, if you just add, you're getting 29, which is the code for Raj. So similarly, just write numbers corresponding to all the alphabets of this word. E corresponds to 5, D is 4, U is 21, This is going to be 3, 1, 20, 9, 15, and 14. If you just add all these numbers, then this is going to be 30 plus 4, 34 plus 20, 54 plus 9, 63 plus 29. It's going to be 92. So the correct option for this is going to be 92. The coding is 92. Okay, so this is how you're going to solve some questions which are based on the position of alphabets. Okay, they're all having their corresponding numbers. We're just adding them to obtain the required code. Now look at the next question. This is a question related to directions. First thing that you need to remember to solve any question of this kind is this direction, sense of direction. So this direction in the upward direction is north, this is south, this is east, and this is west. So you just need to learn, just need to remember these directions first. According to the question, we are just going to draw some arrow diagrams and solve accordingly. Okay, now see, at dusk Rohit started walking facing the sun. So now we all know that at dusk sun will be in the west. So this is how Rohit was standing. Okay, he started walking facing the sun, which means he started walking towards the west. He was walking towards the west. Now after a while he met his friend and both turned to their left. See, now this is where Rohit would be, right? His face would be towards the west. So towards his right is going to be north. This is the right. Here north is going to be there, and at left he is going to have south. Fine, so they turned to their left. Turned to their left means turned towards south. Okay, now they're moving towards south. So he moved towards south. Now they halted for a while and started moving by turning again to their right. Now when they're moving south, towards south, their face is towards south. To their right is west and to their left is east. Now they turned right. Turned right means moved towards west. Moved towards west. Finally, Rohit waved goodbye and took a left turn. Now to the left of Rohit is south. So this is how Rohit would be moving finally. So they're asking in which direction is Rohit moving now. So the answer is going to be south. This is how Rohit was moving. So finally he was moving towards south. So this is the simplest way to solve any direction question. You just draw this type of diagram first. If you just remember, or maybe you just draw this in a corner, and then according to the question, turn right, turn left. Just see which direction is going to be right if you're facing north, which direction is going to be left, and turn accordingly. Make a diagram of this kind and see finally which direction is the answer. Okay, look at the next question. So these type of question, these are known as Venn diagrams. These questions are very easy to attempt, and you can always get the correct option if you're just a little bit careful. So these type of diagrams are used to show relationships, set, subset, okay? Which is like, I'm taking an example first, then you can just see. Suppose I say that I need to make a diagram of humans, men, women. So I need to signify a relationship between humans and men. So we know that men and women both are humans. So men and women, if men is a set A, women is a set B, then A and B both are going to be subsets of the set humans. But men and women are mutually exclusive means no man is going to be woman and no woman is going to be men. Okay, we are not considering transgenders for now. In the general case, men and women are going to be separate sets, individual sets. So this is how, if this represents humans, then this is going to be men, this is going to be women, this is going to be women. Okay, you might be wondering what is all this extra space, who are humans except for men and women. So okay, just ignore it. Okay, maybe, okay, I don't know. So you can just increase the size of sets A and B so that they completely cover the set humans. Maybe we can make sets like this then. Right, this is going to be the set of humans, this is men and women. So there is no interaction intersection between A and B, which means that there is no common point between men and women. Okay, there are a lot of common points between men and women obviously, but what I mean is in a scientific way, no man is going to be woman, no woman is going to be men, but both of them are going to be humans. So this is how we are drawing Venn diagrams to show the relationships. Now this question is asking that which diagram is representing the relation among man, vegetables and cow the best. So you know that no man is going to be vegetable or cow, no cow is going to be vegetable or man, no vegetable is man or cow. So these are three different sets, no intersection between any of them, right? So this option A, first option, is going to represent this. Okay, because there is no intersection, no common point, no common characteristic between men, vegetables and cow. So this is the correct answer. Now this is a question related to assertion and reason. Just see what is the characteristic of a question of assertion reason. See, assertion reason questions, whenever you are getting, they are having four options. First is, see, you'd be given two statements, two separate statements. So what you have to do first is judge each statement separately. See each statement separately and see if the statement is true or not true. If once you have verified that both the statements are true, if any one of the statement is false, then it's very easy. Either you'll have in three or four option. Okay, A is true, R is false, A is false, R is true. If you have judged that both the statements are true, then you have to see either they are related. Is this statement, assertion, related to the reason? Is this reason explaining any point of the assertion? Is this an explanation or an extension of the assertion? So this is how you're going to judge. Okay, just look at an example. First, I'm going to judge both the statements separately. Assertion says a little gap is left between iron rails, which is true. We know that this is true. Now reason says iron expands in summer. This is also true. We know that iron expands in summer. Now just see, does this second statement, does this reason explain this? Is this the reason? Is this the reason that iron expands in summer? Is this the reason because of which a little gap is left between iron rails? Yes, true. So which is why the answer would be A. Both A and R are true. Okay, because both of them are true. Sometimes they'll also give both A and R are true and R explains A. Okay, and second option they're going to give both A and R are true, but they are not interrelated. Okay, so you can judge in this way. Fine. Look at the next question now. So this figure got distorted. Okay, I'll read out the question. From the given answer figure, select the one in which the question figure is hidden or embedded. So what they are trying to ask is, this is the question figure. They just require you to see that in which given figure can you extract this. Okay, which given figure can you find this. So we are going to look at it one by one. In the first figure, see, I have got this diagonal and I have got these two triangles also. So I can find this. Here, see, this is missing, right? I don't have this, so this, I cannot find this. Here, this is not up to the edges, so I cannot find this. And here, the diagonal is not in the correct orientation. So the correct option is going to be first one. In 17th, your correct option is first one. So this was an easy question. You just had to see that where this is fine. What you can do is you can just break this question figure into parts. Okay, like I have I broke it into one diagonal and two triangles, and we can just check for them individually. Okay, like in this figure, orientation was diagonal was not correct, so I rejected this. Here the diagonal was not on complete edges, okay? This was not complete. This was only containing the triangles, but this part was missing. So I can reject it. Here the triangles were not there. The diagonal was there, but the triangles were not there. Okay, so just break this into some parts and then check for the corresponding parts. Look at the next question. Yeah, this kind of questions also you're getting frequently. So a simple way to solve this kind of question is what they've given is they're giving us a piece of paper, and according to these dotted lines they're folding the paper and making some cuttings. Then they're just opening the paper back into the original position, and they want you to tell that what is the final cutout going to look like. Okay, so this is basically based on your imagination. Although there's some tips that you can just note, maybe they'll help. So see, what is happening here is they folded the paper two times, okay? They've just made this square sheet, they folded it into half, then they again folded it. So they've made the square out of the sheet, they've folded it two times. Then they just draw or they just cut this D. Now they are opening it. So see, when they are cutting this D is going to be cut out from all the four sheets. When they are going to open it, this is going to look something like this, okay? From this part, they cut the D. So this is going to be like this only. Now see, when you are going to open this paper, when you are going to open the first fold, which means when this paper is going to look like this, so there it is going to have a mirror image. Fine. Which is why when you fold it back, only then it is going to overlap, right? If I had drawn something like this, it would have been something like this, then it would not overlap. But overlapping is necessary, right? If there would not have been any overlapping, how could you cut once and having two different figures? That's not possible. So this is how the two sheets are going to look, okay? When you have opened one fold, this is how half sheet is going to look. Now when you open it again, so here already we had these. Now when you open it again this is going to have a mirror figure, mirror image. So that when you fold this sheet, these figures can overlap. If you had a figure like this, it would not overlap on folding. It would overlap if you cut it and place it over the second sheet. But we are not doing that. We are just folding. So for folding, this should be a mirror image so that this can overlap. So this is how the sheet is going to look, which is option two. Okay, so one thing that you can remember is whenever you are making a cutout, when you are cutting an image in a sheet, when you unfold the sheet, the image corresponding to other folds, other parts of the paper is going to be the mirror image. So you just keep on unfolding one by one, make mirror images, and then you can just see how the full sheet of paper is going to look. Fine. Look at the next question. If a mirror is placed on the line MN, then which of the answer figures is the right image of the given figure? See, whenever they're placing a mirror, what we are going to do is, I'm just drawing the question figure here for more clarity. See, whenever you are placing a mirror, you placed a mirror here, right? What are we going to do is, we know that mirror image is always one that if you just pick it up from here and put it like this, just flip it, it is going to overlap. So what I am going to do is, I am just going to draw this. Okay, I'm just going to draw it one by one. You can just see, first I have drawn these two lines, then I am drawing this line, then I am making two vertical lines, then I am making the two horizontal lines at the end. From these two horizontal lines, we are having something like this. Okay, we had something like this. So this is how the mirror image is going to look. Now from the options, you can see that this is option two. Okay, so the best way to obtain the mirror figure is just to draw. Just draw, okay? Just see that there are two diagonal lines. Just draw two diagonal lines. Then there is one horizontal line. Draw horizontal line. Two vertical lines. Just draw, okay? As you draw, you can just find out that what is the mirror image. Fine. Look at the next question. See, what they are saying is, they're giving us two matrices according to which alphabets can be addressed. Okay, according to the row number and the column number, according to the row number and the column number, they're representing alphabets, okay? For example, they're representing A as 00 or 23, 0, 0 or 23 or 00. Okay, so this is how they are representing alphabets. Similarly, P they are representing as 55 or 69. Okay, so row number first and column number later, they are representing the alphabets. Now they are saying that which of these options can be the possible representation of the word beast. Fine, so what we are going to do is, first we are going to see that what can be the possible representation of B out of these, okay? So, we are just going to check the options and eliminate. We are just going to solve this question by using the method of elimination. What do we do is, we check all the options. If there is any wrong representation for B, we are going to eliminate it. Then for E, until we get the answer. So, just see out of these options which cannot be a possible representation for B. Only the first one we are checking. See 33. 33 is B. So, first option is correct. 31. 31 is E. 31 is E. So, this option is eliminated. Second option is eliminated because 31 is not a correct representation for B. Then check 24. 24 is B. Then we check 42. 42 is also B. Okay, so we have eliminated one option. Now we are going to check representation for E. Check the first option, 42. 42 is not E, so we can just eliminate it. Now check the third option, 22. 22 is E. Last option is 31. 31 is also E. Now we are going to check representation for A. A 23. So 23 is A, 13 is not A, so we eliminated this also. So the correct option is going to be third one. Correct answer for 20th is going to be 3. Okay, see there are other methods also. One method would be you write all the possible representations for B from this table, then you write possible representations for E, then for A, then S, then T, and then just check which of them is suitable for these options or whatever. But I find that this is the least time taking procedure. Plus, this is the fastest way possible. Elimination is a better way when you have so much of representations, okay? You write representations, then you check. So, that would take a lot of time. Here, see, we just reached the third alphabet and we find out the answer, right? So, whichever way you feel comfortable, but I'd suggest that this is a faster way. So, these were the 20 questions from your first section. Now, we have some questions from GK, General Knowledge. General awareness.